in the muck and mire of mediocrity, staying stagnated and not growing. Listen, Jesus said in Matthew chapter number 9 and verse number 17, he said, neither do men put new wine in the old bottles, else the bottles break, and the wine runs out, and the bottles perish. But they put new wine in new bottles. Are y'all with me tonight? So that they are both preserved. And you need to understand that when he says you can't put new wine in old bottles, the reason why new wine cannot go into old bottles is because when the new wine expands and it ferments and it expands, the old bottles break. Because they are not, they don't have the elasticity. They don't have the ability to be able to expand with the wine. Are y'all with me tonight? And so there are many folk in the church. For some reason, we don't want to be flexible as it pertains to the methods of trying to reach our young folk. Nobody, we don't want to change the doctrine. We don't change the doctrine, but every now and then we got to take a new look at our methods so that we can reach our young people. Y'all with me tonight? This new generation of young folk is presented unto us as new wine. They know Chris Rock, but they don't know Christ the Solid Rock. I'm talking about new wine. They know Alicia Keys, but they don't know about the keys to the king. They know Tyler, but they don't know about Timothy and Titus. They know Sean Paul, but they don't know St. Paul. There are young folk out there. They know rapper Eminem, but they don't know writers Eminem, Matthew, and Mark. They know Ludacris, but they don't know nothing about St. Luke. They know Lil John, but they don't know St. John. They know the Eastside boys, but they don't know the three Hebrew boys. They know John Legend, the singer, but they don't know John the Revelator. They know Dr. Dre, but they don't know Dr. Jesus. They know P. Diddy, but they don't know Diddy about what Peter preached. They know Jay-Z, but they know nothing about Jesus' resurrection on day three. They know 50 Cent, but they don't know nothing about the five steps. They know Beyonce, but they don't know what the Bible say. They know Snoop Dogg, Shizzle, My Nizzle, or the Doggy Fizzle, but they don't know nothing about the Apostle Paul and Pistle. Is presented unto us as new wine. But there are too many churches who have become old bottles that are not flexible enough to let this new generation become a vital part of the development of the church. Y'all with me tonight? One of the things, Brother Michael, that I admire about your father. I told you last night, I'm not trying to shine nobody's shoes. He's not even here tonight, but I admire this about him. Is that he don't mind working with young folk and trying to develop young people. Trying to develop young preachers. Are y'all with me tonight? He started with you when you were young. Amen. Several other preachers been working with and developing and working with Brother Al and bringing him along. And there are very few preachers and brethren these days that are interested in developing young folk. And some of them come from prominent congregations that got big reputation. And I can tell you right now, they are dying on the vine. Listen. If you do not invest, if we don't invest in our young people, the Y'all with me? Because one of these days we gonna leave here. And we gonna have to invest in our young people. I came by tonight to tell you, Eastside, that you don't need to be intimidated by new wine. Old bottles can't stand the new wine of technology. Old bottles can't stand the new wine of new methodologies, and they can't stand the new wine of powerful praise and powerful worship, and they can't stand the new wine of anointed preaching. Listen, you don't have to be an old, you don't have to be old to be an old bottle. Amen. Tell you what I said tonight? You ain't got to be old to be an old bottle. Nor do you have to be young to be new wine or a new bottle. We have a sister at our church at 9th Street, Sister Sally Lofton. She's going to be 101 years old next month, who has been in the church since 1939. And when I get to preaching, and when I start feeling good, Brother Mike, and the preaching get good to her, she jumps on her feet, clap her